As the sun rose over the beach, I had only one plan: to catch a wave at any cost. Surfing was my language, my way of communicating ideas when my pen wasn't enough. Off the board, I was a poet first class, but the real poetry happened on the face of the wave. I'd learned that long ago.
Hey, got room for one more surfer?
Sure, ocean's all yours.
She was interesting. I could tell from the way she handled her board that she surfed. And she said something interesting to me that made me see the ocean in a different light.
These waves, they never stop coming, do they? Cities rise and fall. People are born and they go back to Earth, but there's always waves on the ocean. Funny, right?
Funny, she said. To me, it was more than funny. It was deep, like the words of my favorite writers. It made me think that maybe this was the girl I'd been searching for.
Hey, why haven't I seen you around here before? I surf here every day. It's sort of like my local spot.
I don't like to stay in one place for too long. I get restless if I don't let myself be blown beach to beach by the ocean wind.
You didn't answer my question. Are you from Miami?
No, Jason. I'm definitely not.
Jason? That was a name I'd gone by long ago, before I started surfing. Back then I was a pencil pusher, who knew as much about surf and poetry as probably some nobody. How did she know Jason? And why did she insist on bringing him up, at a time when I needed to focus on my board?
Hey! How'd you know my old name?
You used to work on 3rd Street, right? Office Mart? I worked at the bagel place next door. I always used to deliver for one woman. I forget her name.
Isabel.
Yeah, that's her. She always used to order one bagel extra plain for Jason. Extra plain meaning extra boring. That's you, right, Mr. Boring?
No. That was me. Once. Now the people call me Joaquin. And I live for the surf, for the emotions I express through my poetry. That man you call Jason, the pencil pusher, the freak. He's gone now. Finito. God, why am I explaining myself to you? You're just a bum, a freak. I'd like to see the types of poems that you write. They're probably only 3 lines long.
Hey, I didn't mean anything by it.
Yeah, well, it meant something to me. You pissed me off, so go away. I need to learn new surf moves today.
I needed to forget about this girl. I needed to surf. Once I felt the familiar sea beneath me, all would be forgiven.
You can't change who you are, Jason. You may remember Mr. Boring, but I remember someone else. Someone who walked into my shop when my face was wet with tears because I couldn't make rent. He gave me this. Said it fell off the body of a rabbit and it'd bring me good luck. Figures I'd be holding onto this the day I won the lottery. I didn't just make rent. I used my winnings to buy Office Mart and close it down. That people like that man spread their wings and fly.
Wait a second. You were behind Office Mart's closure? That was the one thing that made me start writing. Stop pushing pencils and pick up my poet's pen.
Well, I'm glad I did, but I never meant for you to turn into somebody that you weren't. Goodbye, Jason. Maybe the ocean isn't big enough for the both of us.
As she walked off of my beach, I thought about what Marlene had said. Maybe she was right. Maybe there was something the poet Joaquin could learn from that old pencil pusher Jason. I didn't need to surf today. Instead, I'd make a trip to Office Mart to see if old Jason had left a rabbit's foot behind for me as well. I guess it's true what they say. The greatest poem we can write is a poem known as life.